people have the desire to change, but sometimes true transformation takes place beneath the skin. Welcome to the world of plastic surgery, before and after.
Hi, I'm Jan Adams, a plastic surgeon from Beverly Hills, California. When I perform reconstructive surgery on someone who survived cancer, I'm going to do everything I can to repair their body with minimal scarring and make them feel great about themselves. And that's just what happens in today's episode. A woman cheats death twice and discovers the amazing way her plastic surgeon mends the scar. You'll also meet a courageous young boy who was born with multiple facial deformities. He travels all the way from Poland to the United States for surgery and a chance at a normal life.
15-year-old Daniel Demby was born with a rare birth defect that left him with severe facial deformities and a hearing impairment. He wears a special device around his skull to amplify sound. But by all other accounts, he's a normal teenage boy who's hoping one day for the chance just to fit in.
So I just want to look like a normal person. Everyone is. But I don't have to be perfect, but just normal.
Life has been a struggle for Daniel from the start. Born in Poland, he was abandoned as an infant. He spent the first 9 years of his life in an orphanage.
Daniel was born with a birth defect called Treacher-Collins syndrome. It affects his hearing, his facial features, and the loss of ears. And in his case, both ears. He just had little stubs. And so he was known, as a little boy without ears.
Treacher-Collins occurs in about 1 in 10,000 births. It usually results in deformed facial features such as malformed ears, drooping eyelids, and recessed cheekbones. Daniel Demby's case is a mild to moderate case, but reconstructing any child with Treacher-Collins requires multiple surgeries and can take several years.
Daniel's reconstruction began in 1998, at the age of 9. His life changed forever when he was granted a medical visa to the United States through Operation Smile. They introduced him to a plastic surgeon in Miami, Florida. In a series of 4 operations, Daniel's ears were rebuilt using his own rib cartilage. The entire process took more than 2 years. Daniel lived in a foster home where Andrea and Ben Demby volunteered.
It made you sad to see this child who was living, I guess, without a mom and a dad.
The feeling and the thought knowing that he did not have a secure home, and we just became a burden on our heart to not to let that continue to happen to him. If it was in God's hand for us to adopt him, then we were going to adopt him. And God put everything into place. So we're here today.
It's been 3 years since the Dembys took Daniel into their home. With lots of love and support, he's flourishing and discovering new talents.
I do have music talents. So once I learn how to read the music, I can almost play any music except flute.
Now that he's 15 and almost done growing, Daniel faces the next chapter of his reconstruction.
You can ask as many questions as you want and try to get as many answers as you can as to what he needs medically, but yet I think you never fully know the extent of what is involved with someone like Daniel.
Today, the Demby family seeks answers from Dr. Johnny Solomon, the plastic surgeon who operated on Daniel's ears 6 years ago.
Hi, Daniel. How have you been?
Good.
Wonderful. Well, today we're here to talk about the other steps of your reconstruction. So what we're going to try to correct for you is the eyes, because the lower lid is a little bit slanted. And we're going to try to narrow the nose for you. And also we're going to try to make the cheeks more prominent for you by putting an implant to get more definitions in the cheek. And I think those 3 steps will make things a lot better. Daniel won the affection and the warmth of everybody. He really is a special child. I was really looking forward to helping him through the process and making him more normal appearing. In terms of going back to school, Daniel, I think after a week you'll be ready to go back to school.
How many weeks will it be before I can play my instrument?
Well, you can play your instrument right away. As long as the pain is not too bad, you can play your instrument even the next day if you wanted to.
Poppy won't play the next day.
I know you did so well the last time with the ear surgery, and so I'm sure you're going to do well with this next surgery.
And it's going to make a big difference.
The evening before the surgery, several friends gather in prayer for Daniel.
Our Father, I thank you so much for this great news, for this chance for my son, and for this chance for all of our friends to share in these moments in our lives. I'd just like to thank you for me and my wife and my son.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
While Daniel hopes this surgery will give him the features he was born with, in Miami, Florida, Daniel Demby is about to undergo his. Dr. Solomon arrives and maps out a plan.
So what we'll do is lower this a little bit, the dorsum of the nose, so that it's not so prominent. Now I'm going to make the markings where the cheek implants are going to be. And now we're gonna do the markings where we're gonna tighten the lower lids a little bit. I think we are done. And I'll see you inside.
Thank you.
In the operating room, Dr. Solomon begins with the cheek implants.
We're gonna start on his left side.
He makes an incision in the upper portion of Daniel's gum.
Now I'm making a plane between the bone and the soft tissue so that we can create a space for that implant, not too big and not too small.
The doctor then slips the implant in through Daniel's mouth and positions it into place. Dr. Solomon repeats the process on the right side.
So fairly symmetrical, which is something we want. It's not overdone. I think they're just the right size for him, and I think we're ready to close. We did the cheek implants first because the cheek implants would dictate exactly how much tightening I can do in the eye, because the cheek implants alone would push the lower lids a little bit, and so I wanted to do that first.
Dr. Solomon makes a small incision in the corner of Daniel's eye. He locates tissue called a tarsal plate along Daniel's lower eyelid.
So I have this tarsal plate completely free now, and I can move it in a more superior direction so we can change it from this kind of an appearance to this kind of an appearance.
The last procedure is the nose. Dr. Solomon shaves down the bridge and removes cartilage from the tip. He uses the same techniques as in a normal rhinoplasty.
So now we're going to proceed and do some work on the cartilages to get them a little bit narrower and define the tip a little bit more.
After he's satisfied with the shape, Dr. Solomon closes the incision. The team wraps Daniel's fragile nose in layers of protective bandages.
Oh, beautiful. Thank you, everybody.
Dr. Solomon heads for the waiting room.
Hello. Everything went beautifully, just as we talked about. All the details, everything went perfectly.
In recovery, Daniel wakes up slowly.
Hi, honey.
Right here,
yeah.
Oh, I feel somebody.
Daniel's dream is to look normal. That's, you know, what he's always saying. I just want to look like the other kids. So hopefully this surgery will help him look like the other kids. I'm sure it will.
Coming up next, find out if this extraordinary boy gets the ordinary look he's hoping for. And Anita finds the courage to undergo surgery once again.
This is my third surgery since being diagnosed with cancer.
15-year-old Daniel Demby was born with Treacher-Collins syndrome, a birth defect that left him with severely deformed facial features and hearing loss. His extensive reconstruction began at the age of 9 when a plastic surgeon in Miami, Florida rebuilt his ears. 2 months ago, his cheeks, nose, and eyelids were repaired in an operation he hopes will fulfill his lifelong dream.
I just want to look like a normal person. Everyone is. But I don't have to be perfect, but just normal.
Today, Daniel is back in full swing with his new look.
Sure.
He also has a smaller, more advanced hearing aid.
What I like the most about my new face is that my cheeks stand out more. And it's more natural look when my cheeks stand out. My eyes curved, which I like it, and my nose got a little bit skinny.
The changes I've seen in Daniel are with his friends. He is more outgoing, and I think he's fitting in better.
When I look in the mirror now, I started to look like other kids. A normal appearance. I have more self-confidence.
What you cooking, Dad?
Burgers.
What I like the most about the results in Daniel is that he now looks like a mature young man with a big and beautiful smile.
Did you know that in the past year, the number of cosmetic procedures for men has increased by 31%? The number one surgical procedure requested was liposuction. Whether it's cosmetic or reconstructive, there's no doubt that plastic surgery is on the rise. And we, the doctors, will continue to find ways to improve procedures and make our patients' requests a reality. I want the patient to be happy. That's the bottom line. I'm Dr. Jan Adams. Thanks for watching.